Hello everyone, I'm Lalit Singh. Welcome back in Android Developers Fundamental course. So we're going to talk more about our delightful user experience lessons. And today's topic would be material design. Yeah, material design. You must have heard about this term a lot. And this is a very new concept launched in Android 5.0 Lollipop API 21. And everybody's afraid about it. But today we're going to talk about in detail about this particular topic itself. So in this particular session, we're going to cover what exactly is material design, how exactly the different components like image, topography, colors, motion, or layouts fits into this. So let's just talk about the material metaphor first. What exactly is material metaphor? So when we talk about material design, it's not just a design pattern. It's actually the design guidelines and the visual language itself, which tells you how exactly you want to design your views, which will imitate just like a material. They are the basic principles and good design patterns which you have to follow in order to get a great material design in your application itself. Okay. So why do we call it material? Because material design relies on real-world material behavior. For example, materials are placed in the three-dimensional environment, right? So when we are designing our buttons or image or any other view, we have to think like that we are placing in a three-dimensional environment. So it will have x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis too. So if we are designing our app for our real world, so our elements and views should cast shadows, occupy space, and interact with each other. There are many guidelines for material design. And as you develop your app, you will sure discover more of them. But for now, let's look at some of the basic ones that will get you going. All of these rules will make sure your UI is simple, easy to navigate, and liberate. Imagery. Now let's just talk about imagery. Some wise men said that image speaks more than words, and it is true. Whenever you get the chance, you should use images in your apps rather than using more and more text. For example, whenever you are using image, it should be relevant, it should be informative, and it should be delightful. You can't just use any image which doesn't even make sense with what you really want to show your user. Now, some of the basic practices should be, you should generally use image with your text. Not too much text, but just the small description of the image itself. And your images should be original. Do not copy all your images. It will lose the originality of your app itself. And provide point of focus. When I say that, that means your image should be to the point and it should be narrative in itself. So let's just talk about few topography guidelines while dealing with material design. By default, Android uses Roboto as the standard typeface, but you can use your own customized typeface also. So when we are designing or when we are putting our fonts, we have to make sure that there should be a unique difference in your title, there should be a unique difference in your subtitle size, or there should be a difference between a normal paragraph. So Android does give you a predefined standard size like display 4, display 3, display 2, display 1. So all these sizes are predefined, but according to your application, you can define your own also. If you want to use the standard one, this is the way to use the standard size. Add the rate style text appearances dot app compact dot display 3. It will give you the size of display 3. That would be 56 SP. Next, colors. When we are using colors, we have to make sure that our colors really gel in with our application. It should be bold at the time we are selecting any paragraph so that user can make out that we have actually selected the paragraphs. The color should be brightly highlighted. And if you are putting any text, the background should also be in contrast with your text itself. In material design, we recommend you to choose primary color with some shades and some accent color. Now, color is a really complex topic. It takes years to master to become a designer. Now, for that, we have a predefined color palette designed for you in which you don't even need to choose, you don't even need to decide which color or which color combination you have to choose. So when I talked about color selection, your color selection will have a primary color, which will be starting from a range of 500 to 800, and your accent color will also have a particular range. Now, you don't have to learn all these ranges. For that, to make things more simpler, we have color selection tool here. Now let's just take a look in color selection tool. Here, you can choose any color which you want in your application, which you want as a standard color, one color or two color together, and which will make your application, it will give you some options to know how exactly you should use your color palette, like for title, primary colors, or some primary text, what should be the color, or primary dark color, what should be the color. So you don't even have to decide yourself. This tool really helps and get you going when you are designing your own applications. So text color should be contrast for visual, and it should be readable, easy to read, and simple. So you can see on the left, there are some good examples and bad examples. Like we can easily make out our first button, good choice, and the green background with white text. But then we see a button with a back with a yellow background, and the next one too. So these are some bad choices which you shouldn't make in your application. Next, motions. Now, motions give you a real good appearances of the material design itself. They will tell you how exactly a material in the real world moves, and you have to intimate the same thing in your own views and components. So, in material design, the motion which you see, they are responsive. They are natural. They are actually intentional itself. So, whatever, all the motion you see, they are smooth. They are being provided by the material design to you. You just have to use the methods there. When we are designing our motions, we need to make sure that there is a continuity. When I say continuity, like if you are, you can see example on my left that that the ball is touching to other smaller balls and keeps going like that. And while it is going, it is also doing the transition and changing the states. And this motion is so smooth that you can make out the smooth motion here. Or on the top, you can see a button. When you click on a button, there is a ripple effect. You can make out that you have actually clicked the button. Okay, now let's just talk about layouts. Now it's time to implement whatever we have learned, all the components like imagery, typography, or your colors to put together. Now, when we are going to design any views and put them in our layout, you need to make sure that views will be designed by DP. That is density independent pixel, and all your text font or font sizes will be put in SP, that is scaling pixel or scalable pixel. Anything you are going to put on your layout should be designed with the grid alignment. I'm going to show you grid alignment in a bit, but before you actually design your layout, you need to plan it. You need to make sure whatever you are designing is actually going to gel in with other views also. There are some templates also you can check out, and you can use these predefined templates for your layout patterns too. Now, here's an example. You can see here that in the very middle, there is a grid alignment of your screen. So it tells you that your screen is divided in all those small pixels. Each cell constitute in a pixel. Now, on the rightmost side, you can see that there is an avatar, which is nothing but 48 cross 48 dp. That is the size. Now, I want to put this avatar, let's say on the very left, you can see an inbox application, inbox activity. I want to put this avatar in each row. Now, I need to plan in starting only that this each row will contain this 48 cross 48 image, and the text views will have its own width, and accordingly the second text view. Now, this spacing and this image will be a consistent for each and every row. And that's how you need to plan each and every layout in the very starting. Now let's just talk about components. Now, material design gives you a whole bunch of components. We are going to discuss few of them, like cards. Cards is really a new addition to your material design, or your dialogues, new dialogues, sliders, snack bar. Snack bar is nothing but just like your toast dialog box, but it lets the user interact with you. So you can check out all those new components of material design here and use them in your Android application, which will give you a complete material design pattern for your application, for your own application. Now, there are some more components which you might have came across, like expansion panels. Whenever you scroll down, your app, your action bar shrinks. Whenever you scroll up, your action bar again expands. So that's what actually a component of your material design. List, recycler view, pickers, progress bar. So all these cool components are being provided to you by material design, which you can actually use in your application. Now, consistency. Consistency really helps the user to actually navigate through your application. For example, let's say you created an application in which you created a floating action button at the bottom, which is adding the contacts. Now, when you go to the next activity, now you add the same floating button at the top. Now, the functionality doesn't change. It will still be able to add. But the problem here is the user was already comfortable of using that fab button at the bottom. Now you have changed the whole designing pattern. This will make them uncomfortable, right? So in the same way, you can design like navigational drawer. Navigational drawer needs to be always open up from the very top by three buttons. Now you can design a separate button for that. But again, user is not comfortable with using the navigation with a separate button. It should be at the top. So all these things need to be taken care whenever you are designing your material design app. You should definitely check out all these links. Material designing is a massive topic, but a really important one. Next, we are going to see the practical on material design.